فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. وإن شرح of the كتاب الأجرومية and we're specifically relying on the شرح which is التحفة السنية بشرح المقدمة الأجرومية written by محمد محيدين عبد الحميد رحمهم الله. May Allah be pleased with the author and the شارح, the explainer. We stopped at باب معرفة علامات الإعراب, and we're going to start from there إن شاء الله تعالى. The author rahimahullah, he says babu, the chapter knowing alamat al-i'rab. Before we go into babu ma'rifat alamat al-i'rab, I now want to ask you all a question. What is it that we do i'rab of? And I've written on the board what we do i'rab of. These are the 8 things that we do i'rab of. So remember ism mudhar, Sa'ad. Ism mudhar, which is 6 that come under that. Al-ism mufrad, al-muthanna, jam'u al-taksir, jam'u al-mu'annath al-salim, jam'u al-mudhakkar al-salim, al-asma'u al-khamsa. And the fi'il, 2 come under that. What was it? Al-fi'il al-mudari' al-ladhi lam yatasi bi akhirhi shay. And the second one is al-af'al al-khamsa. Those 8 are what we do i'rab of. So babu ma'rifati alamat al-i'rab, the 4 signs that the author already mentioned to you, which was al-raf'u wal-nasbu wal-jazmu wal-khafdu. Al-khafdu wal-jazmu. Al-raf'u wal-nasbu wal-khafdu wal-jazmu. Those 4 signs that you learned, you just need to know how these 8 enter it. These 8 only enter into 2, into raf and nasb. Does that make sense? These 8 fully, all 8 of them, will only be used fully in al-raf'u wa al-nasbu. But al-khafd is specific to which 6? The ism mudhar, fi'il, doesn't come into khafd. And when we say jazm, what's the only thing that comes in there? The fi'il. Are we all together? So we really just have to focus on al-raf'u wa al-nasbu properly, and realize how these 8 are going to enter into al-raf'u and also al-nasbu. Inshallah ta'ala, today's lesson, we just need to study each one of these 8. So we're going to fully study 8 of these. What's the ism mufrad? What's the muthanna? What's the jam'u taksir? What's the jam'u mu'annath salim? What is the jam'u mudhakkar salim? What is al-asma'u al-khamsa? What is al-fi'l al-mudari' al-ladhi lam yatasil bi-akhirih shay? What is af'al al-khamsa? What do they mean? So we're going to study each and every one of those 8. And then we're going to learn how they enter into each one, insha'Allah ta'ala. Does that make sense? Let's start, insha'Allah ta'ala, with al-ism al-mufrad. Let's start with al-ism al-mufrad. All of you go to the sharah of Tuhfat al-Saniyah, بشرح المقدمة الأجرومية. محمد محي الدين عبد الحميد says أما الاسم المفرد. For me it's page 29. What is it for you? For me it's 29. أما الاسم المفرد. As for the singular noun, فَالْمُرَادُ بِهِ هَاهُنَا, the intent that is meant by it here is مَا لَيْسَ مُثَنَّا وَلَا مَجْمُوعًا وَلَا مُلْحَقًا بِهِمَا وَلَا مِنَ الْأَسْمَاءِ الْخَمْسَةِ. Ism mufrad is whatever is not muthanna. Ism mufrad, it can't be a muthanna. It's whatever is not a muthanna. And it is whatever is not majmu'an, which is any of the 3 plurals. So muthanna means dual, is anything that's dual, it's not dual. Okay? مَا لَيْسَ مُثَنَّن, anything that's not dual. وَلَا مَجْمُوعًا, and it's not plural. وَلَا مُلْحَقًا بِهِمَا, and it is not mulhaq to them. What's a mulhaq? Mulhaq is like kila and kilta. What does mulhaq mean? Is when this word is only found as a dual. It's never found as a singular. Sah? The word kilta is always dual. This is, it takes the ruling of a dual. Because the dual originally is, it comes from a what? Singular, right? Are you there? Yad, yad, yadani. You say, right? Hand, 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 two hands, right? Lakin kilta, ama kila, a muthanna. Sorry, they're mulhaqul muthanna. They're not muthanna because they don't have no singular. They don't have no singular. It's only found as a dual. It's only found as a dual. So whenever you hear mulhaqul muthanna, that's what it means. Don't worry, we're going to study that soon. Come back again. وَلَا مِنَ الْأَسْمَاءِ الْخَمْسَةِ, and it also can't be from what? It also can't be from the أَسْمَاءُ الْخَمْسَةِ. What does that mean? It can't be from the five sisters. And inshallah ta'ala, we're going to take what الْأَسْمَاءُ الْخَمْسَةِ is. Example for this is جَاءَ مُحَمَّدٌ. جَاءَ مُحَمَّدٌ. Muhammad came. وَالْفَتَى, and the boy. So جاء is a فعل ماضي مبني على الفتح لا محل له من الإعرابي. محمد is a what? What's محمد? It's a اسم. It's a اسم مفرد. Muhammad is only one person, right? Does that make sense? محمد is what? It's a اسم مفرد. It's a singular noun. Why? How do we know it's a singular noun? لأن محمد is not مثنى. It's not majmu'an, and it is not wala mulhaqan bihima. So it's not mulhaqul muthanna, and it's not also mulhaqul jama'. It's not. Wala min al-asma' al-khamsa. And Muhammad is not from the five sisters. Muhammad is singular. It's one person, one name, one individual. Good. Fata is ism mufrad as well, right? A boy. The boy. Good. So now we know what ism mufrad means. Ism mufrad is a singular noun. It's a what? It's a singular noun. It's what? ما ليس مثنى ولا مجموعا ولا ملحقا بهما. So it's not ملحق المثنى. Okay? What's an example of ملحق المثنى? كلا and what? كلتا. What about mulhaq al-jam'? Like 20. 20 is mulhaq al-jam', mudhakkar salim. It's mulhaq of jam' mudhakkar salim. Because it's only found in this way. 20 is not found in what? A singular. Good. Very good. Now we're going to move on to the next one. What's it? What's the next one? We're going to move on to the next one, which is? The next one in the on the board is not on the board, but the order is wrong. There is jam'u taksir. Let's move on to the next one, which is jam'u taksir that the author here mentions, Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid. وَأَمَّا جَمْعُ التَّكْسِيرِ فَالْمُرَادُ بِهِ جَمْعُ التَّكْسِيرِ. What's meant by it? مَا دَلَّ عَلَى أَكْثَرَ مِنْ اثْنَيْنِ أَوْ اثْنَتَيْنِ مَعَ التَّغَيُّرِ فِي صِيغَةِ مُفْرَدِهِ. Pay attention. جَمْعُ التَّكْسِيرِ is whatever indicates and shows more than two male or more than two females. مَعَ تَغَيُّرٍ, with changing, alteration. فِي سِيَغَةِ مُفْرَدِهِ, the structure of its word, the structure of the wording will also change. مَا دَلَّ عَلَى أَكْثَرَ مِنْ اثْنَيْنِ, it's anything that indicates. دَلَّ means indicate. عَلَى أَكْثَرَ مِنْ اثْنَيْنِ, it indicates more than two. Male. Or اثْنَتَيْنِ, or two females. Ma'atagayyurin, with alteration and changing. Fi sigati mufradihi, in the structure of its singular. Are we all together on that? Does that make sense? Now, the taghayyur, the changing, happens in jam'u taksir in six ways. That's where the author mentions it to you. وَأَنْوَاعُ التَّغَيُّرِ. So the word is going to change. The word was what? رَاجُلٌ. رَاجُلٌ. The word, is it going to change? It changes from رَاجُلٌ. It changes into what? رِجَالٌ. So it's رَاجُلٌ. That's singular. جمع التكسير is what? رِجَالٌ. Pay attention here. We have the word رَاجُلٌ. رَاجُلٌ. Are we all together? We have the word رَاجُلٌ. This word, رَجُلٌ, if I now want to make a جَمْعُ taksir, what do? ري, I first have to change the كسرة. The fatha that was on the ra changes into كسرة. And then it becomes what? جَالٌ. رِجَالٌ. So what happened? مَا دَلَّ عَلَى أَكْثَرَ مِنِ اثْنَيْنِ. Does the word رِجَال, men, does it show more than two? It does. مَعَ تَغَيُّرِ سِغَتِهِ, with the form and the structure of the word changing. Is that happening? Did the form of the word change? It did change. Does that make sense? It changed. This changing of the جَمْعُ التَّكْسِير is how many types? Six types. He's going to now tell you. I've just showed you one type. Are we all together? It changes in six different ways. Everything, I'm bringing it from the sharah of Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid from the Tuhfatu Saniya. Let's look at the first one. The example's on the book. You can just open your book and you'll see the example. The first one is, وَأَنْوَاعُ التَّغَيُّرِ الْمَوْجُودَةُ فِي جُمُوعِ التَّكْسِيرِ سِتَّةٌ. The types of changing that are present in جُمُوعُ التَّكْسِيرِ, the plural, the broken plural word, is سِتَّةٌ, six times. The first one, تَغَيُّرٌ بِالشَّكْلِ. تَغَيُّرٌ بِالشَّكْلِ. The only thing that changes, the singular and the جَمْعُ التَّكْسِيرِ, the only difference between them is a shakl. That's the haraka changes. He gives you an example. نحو like أسادٌ, one lion. How do you make it plural? أُسْدٌ. The letters are still the present. The alif, seen, dal is there. Ponder here. You have the word أَسَادٌ. أَسَادٌ. أَسَادٌ, what is it? One lion. If you make it plural, what does it become? أُس. أُسْدٌ. What changed? What changed? The shakl changed. What changed? The shakl of the word changed. The alif is still there, the seen is still there, and the dal is still there. So the first form of changing is تَغَيُّرٌ بِالشَّكْلِ لَيْسَ غَيْرُ. The only thing that changes is بِالشَّكْلِ فَقَط. بِالشَّكْلِ فَقَط. The only thing that changes is the shakl. Like أَسَادٌ أُسْدٌ نَمِرٌ نُمُرٌ. A namir is a what? It's a leopard or a cheetah, I don't know. Cheetah, I think. Is that a tiger? So tiger, yeah. They're all the same to me. Are we all together? Yeah. Are you sure? It's a tiger. Yeah? Yeah, right, you're right, that's it. Okay, what about a cheetah? Jaguar? Panther? Asadun ustun. Namirun numurun. What is it? Numurun. So namirun numurun. The author, the Shaykh Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdulhamid says to you, فَإِنَّ حُرُوفَ الْمُفْرَدِ The singular letters, وَالْجَمْعِ and the plural, فِي هَذَيْنِ الْمِثَالَيْنِ In the two examples, مُتَّحِدَةٌ are both the same. وَالْإِخْتِلَافُ بَيْنَ الْمُفْرَدِ وَالْجَمْعِ The difference between the singular one, which is أَسَدٌ, وَالْجَمْعِ أُسْدٌ The only difference between them, إِنَّمَا هُوَ فِي شَكْلِهَا is only shakl. They're the same in the letters. Second way it changes. Second, تَغَيُّرٌ بِالنَّقْصِ لَيْسَ غَيْرُ A letter is going to be taken. One letter has to be taken from it. Are we all together? That's only, the only thing is a reduction of a letter. The shekel does not change. For example, Tuhamatun, suspicion. Tuhamatun is what? It's one suspicion. If you want to make it plural, what do you say? Tuhamun. You just take the ta' marbut off. This is called what? Bin naqsi. Tagayyurun. Bin naqsi. Here it's changing, but by taking a letter off. Tuhamatun. Tuhamatun is what? What's it called? Saliva thing that comes out of a person. Yeah. Spit or whatever. Or the mucus or whatever. Are we all together? Or tuhamatun actually, no. Tuhamatun actually, to be more precise, it's actually when the person burps and a bad smell comes from them. That's exactly, to be precise, that's what it is. Tuhamatun is one. Tuhamun is what? Is plural. The difference between the two. فَأَنْتَ تَجِدُ الْجَمْعَقَ النَّقَصَ حَرْفًا فِي هَذَيْنِ الْمِثَالَيْنِ وَهُوَ التَّاء You can see that the only difference here is what? One letter has been taken. وَبَاقِ الْحُرُوفِ عَلَى حَالِهَا فِي الْمُفْرَدِ And the other letters are in the situation of the singular and the plural the same. They're the same. صحيح؟ You have the ta, you have the ha, you've got the mean, still there. The shakl is still the same. Good. The third type of changing. تغيرون بزيادة. تغيرون بزيادة. Now, what is it? The changing here is by adding something onto it. What do you add onto it? You're adding a letter. So the singular and the plural, the difference between the two is what? What's the difference? What's the difference between the two? Yeah? So تغير بالزيادة It's a changing with what? Nothing else. So it's just only adding something on. Like the word sinwun. Sinwun is a what? It's a tree, one branch tree. Sinwun is one. Sinwanun. What happened to sinwun and sinwanun? What's the difference? Alif and Noon has been added into it. And the ayah in Surah Al-Ra'd, what does Allah say? Sinwun. وَغَيْرُ سِنْوَانٍ Sinwun. وَغَيْرُ سِنْوَانٍ That's the example. So it's tree, and trees, a branch, if you some scholars say. Are we all together? Good. Number four, تغيرٌ في الشكل مع النقص, changing in the shakl and also a letter's been taken off. The example here is سريرٍ and what? سرورٍ. سريرٍ, سرورٍ. كتابٍ, كتبٍ. أحمرٍ, حمرٍ. أبيضٍ, بيضٍ. All of those. What happened here? The shakl got changed. Huh? What got changed? The shakl got changed. It was sa-ri-rin. What did it change into? Su-ru-rin. And the ya got taken out. Ah. How? Number three is just that something's been added to it. But has any of the shakl changed? So we have the word here. Yeah, harakat. The shakl means harakat. The harakat's still the same. Look at the word. Sin. Sinwun. Sinwun. Kasra. Sukun. Does it make sense? Don't look at this word, yeah? This is the waqf. You have to stop there anyways. Don't look at the last letter. So it's si, sinwu. Sah? Sinwu, you say, right? Are we all together? Make it plural. Sin wanun. Sin wan. So what happened? Kasra, sukun. Forget this letter. So has anything changed from the word? Are we all together? Nothing's changed. The haraka is still the same. Does that make sense? Like in the word sarirun. Sarirun, right? Make it plural. Sururun. What happened? First of all, the fatha changed into kasra, dhamma. Sah? Also, the ya got taken off. There's no ya here anymore. Does that make sense? So the shakl has changed and a naqs has happened. Shakl has changed and a naqs has happened. Kitab, also kutubun. Ahmar, humr. Abyad, bild. All of that. Number five. Taghayyurun fi shakli ma'a ziyada. Everyone knows what sarir means, right? And surur. What does it mean? Yeah? You all know, right? Good. Taghayyurun fi shakli ma'a ziyada. Changing that happens. The word gets changed. Shakl gets changed and there's something added onto it. Shakl is changed and something is also added onto it. Like the word sabab. Sabab and asbab. So shakl has changed because the scene, what did it have on it? Fatha. And now what does it have on it? Sukun. Ziyada happened. What happened? What's the ziyada? Alif. There's alif that came twice. So there's hamza and alif that came. At the beginning there's a hamza. And after this, between the two bats, there's what? There's an alif. Like the word batal. You guys know what batal is, right? What's batal? Yeah? No, batal is a hero. Abtal are heroes. Hind, hunud. Sabu'in. Do you know what sabu'in is? Predator. Siba'. Dhib. You guys know what dhib is, right? Yeah? What about hyena? Huh? Daba'a, good. Shuja'a. Courageous, brave person. Shuja'an. You see what happened here? Shakal changed. There's also ziyada. Last but not least, تغير في الشكل مع الزيادة والنقص جميعا. All of them happens. شكل زيادة نقص. All of it. صح. Example for that is the word كريم. The word كريم. Let's look at the شكل. ك. When you want to make a plural, what do you say? كو. So his شكل did change. زيادة. What's the زيادة? كريم. كرماء. The زيادة here is there's an ألف here. That wasn't there. نقص كريم has a ya. كرماء, the ya has been dropped. Does that make sense? So this is شكل مع الزيادة والنقص جميعا. All of them. رغيف. رغيف is what? Yeah, it's a piece of bread. You're right. What's the jam' for it? رغفان. Good. كاتب, كتاب, أمير, أمراء. This is تغير في الشكل مع الزيادة والنقص جميعا. What, pay attention now. The قاعدة that you need to memorize is that whatever form of changing that it comes with amongst those six from جمع التكسير, it is always مرفوع بالضمة. Just remember that. And we're going to elaborate on that later, inshallah ta'ala.